Hi students, today we are going to do one most famous short story of the French author Guy de Maupassant. Guy de Maupassant was a 19th century French author remembered as a master of the short story form and as a representative of the naturalist school who depicted human lives and destinies and social forces in this illusion and often pessimistic terms. He was born on 5th August 1850 and died on 6th July 1893 at Passy, Paris, which is located in France. The necklace or the diamond necklace is an 1884 short story by French writer Guy de Maupassant. It is known for its twist ending, that is ironic ending, which was a hallmark for the Maupassant style. The necklace is a famous short story and morality tale that is widely read in classrooms throughout the world. The necklace is an ironic story about the distinction between appearance versus reality. Our major character is Mathilde Loaves, the greedy wife of a small-time clerk who seeks wealth and believes it will bring her happiness. She remains unhappy in her middle-class status and makes efforts to appear wealthy and glamorous for a fancy party. She borrows jewels from her rich friend and wears a beautiful gown, but her happiness is fleeting, short-lived when she loses the necklace and is forced to spend the rest of her life paying off the debt to replace it. The short story, The Necklace by Guy de Maupassant, takes place in France several hundred years ago. Mathilde Loisel lives in a flat with her husband, who works as a clerk for the Minister of Education. Their lives are not luxurious, not much lavish, but they are not poor, merely simple. Mathilde Loisel borrows a necklace from her friend Madame Forestier. Mathilde's husband has secured an invitation to a party hosted by his boss, the Minister of Public Instruction and Education. When Mathilde worries that she doesn't have anything to wear, her husband agrees to buy her a new dress. The week of the party, Mathilde seems anxious again. When her husband asks her why, she frets that she has no jewelry to wear with her dress. He suggests that perhaps she could borrow something from her friend Jean Forestier. Mathilde goes to Jean's house and picks out a sparkling diamond necklace to borrow. She and her husband attend the gala and have a fabulous time. Mathilde looked dazzling throughout the party. Her beauty was breathtaking. She amused everyone by her appearance. All the men thought that she was the prettiest woman at the party, and she dances until 4 in the morning. Upon her return, she notices that the necklace she borrowed is missing. The husband and wife looks every nook and corner they have been the last night, but all efforts are futile. Embarrassed, the couple spends their entire inheritance and takes out loans to pay off a replacement necklace. To get some more time, Mathilde writes to her friend that she broke the clasp and is having it repaired. In the meantime, they find another necklace that matches the missing one, but it costs 36,000 francs. Her husband fortunately inherited 18,000 francs from his father, but they will need to borrow the rest of the money. Finally, they have enough to purchase the replacement necklace, and Mathilde gives it to Jean, who doesn't even look at it. Mathilde and her husband spend the next 10 years scrimping and saving to pay off their debts. The menial housework ages Mathilde prematurely to the point where Madame Forestier doesn't even recognize her after 10 years. One day she sees Jane Foster on the street. She decides to tell her the truth about the necklace. Jane is stunned by Mathilde's rough appearance. Mathilde explains that it is indirectly because of Jane, since she lost the necklace she borrowed from her and had to pay for a replacement. The wealthy friend reveals that the original necklace was actually just a replica, just a copy. It wasn't a real diamond necklace. It was worth only 500 francs. One of the central themes of the necklace is that of appearance versus reality. For Mathilde, the necklace symbolizes wealth, beauty, and ultimately shame as she loses the necklace and goes into debts to replace it. The great irony of the story is that the necklace was a fake. One surprisingly uplifting theme of this short story is that the fact that it seems happiness comes from being content with whatever one has. I hope you liked the video. Please subscribe to our channel to gain more knowledge about English literature. Contact to join our face-to-face classes. Thanks again for watching the video.